All I smell is fries, man.
Mic check testing 1, 2. Mic check test.
Mic check 1, 2.
Mic check 1, 2. That's a little bit better.
A little loud.
Yep. Okay, let's hear this thing. Go ahead, Bart. Give it to me. Or let me hear it. Mic check 1, 2.
Mic check 1, 2. Mic check 1, 2. Mic check 1, 2. I put the on-ice air mic in a good spot.
Okay, check 2, 3, 4. Hello. Hi, good everybody. Check 1, 2. Mic check test 2. And good evening, ladies and gentlemen, from the St. Louis Park Rec Center. It's high school hockey, the game of the week on letsplayhockey.com. The 2-0 Hill Murray Pioneers will be taking on the Red Knights of Benilde St. Margaret's, who enter this game 1-2 on the season. And along with Bart Archer, I'm Pete Wagner. Of course, our producer, Brett Michaels. Brett Johnson, thanks for joining us here. Bart, let me tell you, this is a game for the Red Knights. There's been a lot of discussion. 17 players have graduated from this roster or left early. Take your pick. And for Ken Pauley, it's a new-look addition. It's a younger team. There's one defenseman that played the position that was on the roster last year. However, He says, without the Bessie superstar power, I still like how this team works.
Well, and as you talked about, as we've talked about leading up to this, Pete, they don't really have that high-end talent like the Grant Bessies or the, I can't for the life of me remember his name, but they're relying more on the committee. It's more accumulation of the team picking.
You're thinking
each
Lebowski.
Other. I'm thinking of Danny Lebowski.
You're thinking TJ Moore.
Absolutely.
You're thinking Augie Moore.
Well, there's a lot of stars that have come through this program.
Johnny Austin.
And really, it didn't start out where they were stars in some cases, where they evolved. And I think with the transference of responsibility to these young kids, it's going to take them a while to kind of get their footing beneath them. But I think, you know, again, I use the holidays as a good gauge because it's about the halfway point of the season. Coaches have a pretty good idea what they have to work with. And I think Benilde St. Margaret's is going to go onward and upward. But, Pete, as you said, they're 1-2, played the first three games at home. This one's at home as well. What a great time for them to kind of right the ship. And I'm sure Ken Pauley's eager to get this game underway.
Well, the one thing about being an independent schedule like the Red Knights of Benilde St. Margaret's are, you control your schedule. You don't have to worry about those conference games. And really, five of their first six games are right here in the friendly confines of the St. Louis Park Rec Center. They opened up the campaign with a 4-1 loss to St. Michael Albertville, and then it was an overtime loss to the Marshall School Duluth, rather win 4-3, and then a loss to the Grand Rapids Thunderhawks, number 3 ranked team in the state, that one by a score of 5-0 just a couple of days back. Meanwhile, when you take a look at the Hill-Marie Pioneers, they've been perfect so far this year, and they have their traditional schedule. It's very similar with how they start the campaign. And once again, they came up with a nice big 4-1 win over the Burnsville Blaze, which is always a good gauge, really, for both those teams.
Yeah, not only that, but they actually limited the shots on goal, only 18 shots on goal against a pretty good Burnsville squad. But Betty Yo, Nath, and Bremer involved in the scoring. So a little bit of diversity in the scoring coming from this Hill-Marie Pioneer squad.
Absolutely mixing it up. And they go on and defeat the Eastview Lightning by a score of 8-3. Of course, that is a state champion section champion Eastview team. So a nice start for Bill Lechner's Hill-Marie Pioneers. I think he definitely likes what he has here in this edition. And we should see a team that's going to be able to skate, play with some physicality, and also create plenty of scoring chances. But Jake Begley, as good of a goaltender as you're going to get in goal, Bart.
Yeah, in fact, he's given up only one goal so far this season. Of course, he's splitting duty with John Egger. But this Hill-Marie squad, you know, a Bill Lechner coach squad always plays a very disciplined game, a very fundamental game, but they always make you defend all areas of the ice, and I don't expect anything different tonight.
Will this be a team from the Benilde St. Margaret's that are going to want to continue to stretch the ice both north and south and east and west? They like to let the puck do the work for them, play it to the open spaces. Or is this a team that will become a little more mechanical and methodical in their offensive approach?
Well, I think that's something that's yet to be determined, really, Pete. I think early in the season, I'm sure that they're showing some indications of both, because Benilde, if there's one commonality that they've had, it's a good team speed. But I think they have to mind the defensive zone first and foremost before they can worry about anything else.
Creativity is Ken Pauley's calling card. Structure Bill Lechner's. We'll have the face-off right after this. The Red Knights of Benilde St. Margaret's and the Pioneers of Hill-Marie will square off here on letsplayhockey.com along with Bart Archer and Brett Johnson. I'm Pete Wagner. Of course, cameraman extraordinaire Todd Grover, our statistician Joey Hench is all in the house here tonight. Bart, game two on our big schedule this year. Next week, we're going to be at the Edina Holiday Classic. Look out.
Yeah, in fact, I got a call from Creed Durham Hall saying they had to clean up a bunch of rust underneath my chair, but I feel like we got the kinks out.
Rust-Oleum. They're not a sponsor, but why not?
And no more squeaking from the joints anymore.
Wow.
But Pete, you did talk about Benilde St. Margaret's playing against the Grand Rapids team. Lost 5-0. Very unusual for Benilde St. Margaret's number one to be shut out, but there's the cast of characters. This is going to be a very good Grand Rapids squad. Micah Miller, two goals and an assist. Gavin Heen, a goal and an assist. So McLaughlin, three assists on that one. Stayskull in goal, 29 save shutout. So they ran into kind of a buzzsaw from Grand Rapids. But what that's going to do is that's going to open up their – they're going to be very motivated coming in. But this promises to be a really pretty solid up-and-down game.
Looking forward to what's going to be offered here tonight between these two teams. And we will be facing it off in a matter of moments. One of the great rinks to call a hockey game and watch a hockey game from. Bart Archer asked the question, did we go with new lighting? No, we didn't, Bart. You know what we did?
They cleaned them.
We painted the walls.
They dusted them.
They painted the walls white.
Oh, it's awful bright in here, pleasing.
It can make a huge difference when you paint the walls white, and that's what happened. We are underway as the Red Knights control in their own zone. On it's Schweitzer with it, plays it to the left wing side. Moran will cross into the Pioneer zone as Yo will play that off the end boards, and it's gathered in by Helgeson. He'll play to center. Foot race ensues. On it is Petronik. And Petronik will play back in deep in the Red Knight zone. Peter Moran is there. He's a veteran of this edition. Puck is poked to safety up the right wing boards by Schweitzer, but he's cut off quickly. Yo works one-on-two in the corner, tried to get the position, but the Red Knights up the right wing side, back into the center ice area it goes, sent in by the Pioneers as they'll work the wholesale. Red Knights will wind it up out of their own zone with it. That's McLeod. No relation to Gopher announcer Doug McLeod. $5 cigars, the whole metallurgy, we're all here. Across the line, there's a shot that's off the shin pads. That's Jerome Newhouse, the junior. They'll play it off the boards. There's a shot that's buzzed wide. That one taken by Neubauer as he goes down behind the net, gathered in there by Jordan Rue. Rue and a long line of Rue brothers that have been in the Red Knight system so far as the Pioneers will play this one rink wide. Bounding puck into the neutral zone, hops the stick of Tischler of the Pioneers, and it's sent right back in. Barr back in behind the net. That gets away from Rue, and turning it back up ice quickly are the Pioneers of Hill Murray. Tischler with it across the line, guides it in on goal. Is that Zach Everett, who's 1-1 in the season for the Red Knights, with a 2.46 and a 9.15 save percentage. Outlet to the right wing. Barr's pass fails to click, and over to gather in, it's Ooner. Right, ooh, that one's right in front of you. You can feel that one right through your speakers. Newhouse has it. Looks to his right for Nate Clark. Clark going to regroup back in behind for Newhouse wearing sweater number 41. Off the boards, left wing side. Pinching there are the Pioneers, and it's going to be sent right back in by the Red Knights. Behind the net, on it's Clark. Clark will play it off the boards. Handled by Newhouse in the skates. That fails to click for Joe Collins. Now behind the net it goes. Clark with it, right wing side, nice touch pass. They'll carry through center. That's Jablonski with it. Max Jablonski just offside as the referees will face off at center ice.
Yeah, it was a bit of a challenge by Emmett Nath on that one. It actually forced Jablonski to cut up at the blue line. But Pete, if there's one thing that the Benilde St. Margaret's has to do is have to be very efficient in their zone exits. Hill Murray is not very aggressive on the forecheck, but they're very effective on that forecheck. So zone exits are going to be paramount for this Red Knight squad tonight.
Schweitzer goes rink wide. McLeod, that's off a pair of skates. And it's going to be Schweitzer again to regroup for McLeod. Left wing side he goes. That's deflected off a stick and back into the Pioneer zone. Petronik is there. He's bothered on the forecheck by the Red Knights. They look for the turnover, but instead back out of the zone come the Pioneers. Speedy through, it's Bremer. And just offside at the line. Oh! Little extra how's she going there off the side of the net. No harm, no foul.
No, but it's a moment of concern. That was Ben Helgeson that actually got taken into the end boards. But it was Peter Moran on a very energetic back check on that one. It's good to see your leaders, a team captain, coming back from the offensive zone on a very solid back check to really thwart that play. But he's going to take a penalty on that one. But, you know, some people might say that's not a bad penalty to take. But now Hill Murray, nary a power play goal so far this season, looking to get something on the scoreboard on special teams, but they're going to get an advantage. 14-11 left in this first period. Still no score. Hill Murray on the power play.
Looking to work the special team package are the Pioneers.
And the penalty kill for this Red Knight squad's hovering around the 73% mark, so room for improvement.
Faceoff played into the corner. Handled by Yo. Gives off to his line mate, Weston Neubauer. Loose puck is swatted at, played the length of the ice. That was Hain on it, Dylan Hain, the junior. Now the Pioneers of Hill Murray will set up and bring it back out of the zone. Power play time continues here for a minute, 34 seconds. And it's sent back in by the Red Knights of Bonneville St. Margaret's. Breezy is there. On the tape, through this neutral zone, it's Bremer with speed to the forehand of the backhand. Big save. Another save, rebound. Oh, they kept it out of the net. A shot that hits traffic. Pucks loose. And Everett was there, sprawling, going Hasek, the best of, with the best of them. Keeps it out of the net. It's nothing.
Boy, there's a huge point of concern as Brock Bremer, one of the primary offensive threats, came in, used his speed, worked his edges, got in tight on Everett, but Everett held his ground, really came out with a great save. Look at him work those angles right there. Kind of a shallow angle, but got it in front, went to the backhand, but that's when all the heck broke loose. But look at Everett trying to hold his ground. If we could have continued that for a moment, he made an outstanding Dominique Hasek-like save to keep that puck out of the net. But don't say Margaret's dodged a bullet.
And the ensuing faceoff control on the power play for the Pioneers. That pass is guided through the slot area by Betty with a minute remaining of the man advantage. Little give and go out of the corner. Nice play there by Betty. Like his control on the puck for sure. Petronik now gives off left wing side. Sontag's shot hits a pair of skates. Pick back up out of the corner. Sontag top of the circle. Oh, deflected just wide. A nice setup down low.
Yeah, I think he was going for the deflection on that one. Pretty heady play.
There's a shot that gets through and blocker pad save. Nice focus by Everett through the traffic. 27 to go in the man advantage. From the right point to the left they go. Sontag shot, stick save, rebound. Oh, it poked out of there. Another puck's loose. Nice work by Everett to keep that puck out of the net. Poked it away from harm's way. From the right side, handled by Knaff to the low slot area. This second unit right now for the Pioneers looking quite good, generating scoring chances. The first one as well. It's only a matter of time before they will strike Bart with their first power play tally and many to come this year.
And Everett's done a great job of keeping that zero on the scoreboard. Now we're back 5-on-5.
McLeod off the end wall, looks to play it up to the right wing side. Good positioning there by Scott Moyer of the Pioneers to force the turnover. Now they'll battle 2-on-2 from the corner. Who wants it? To the right wing side it goes. That's Michael McNeil as he plays ahead to center. McLeod now on it across the line. The big frame and just offside.
Well, challenge at the blue line forced him to cut, and Collins went in offside. But really that play started with Jablonski, and that'd be Max Jablonski, the senior forward, down in his own corner. Nice stick side check separated from the puck and started that breakout. But unfortunate situation for Benilla because they had numbers going in. Face off outside the Hill Murray zone.
Controlled now by the Red Knights. Jablonski stood up right in front of the turnbuckle. And it'll be the Pioneers to try to work the right wing breakout on the ring. Stick save made by Begley. And back into the neutral zone it goes. Left wing side stood up and shivered on the play. It was Moyer being watched by Spindler. Pinching from the right side. It's Breezy. That hits a pair of skates in the neutral zone. And McNeil comes away. Plays it to open ice. Spindler across the line, steps up on the play. He's going to be jammed on the wall by Breezy as he gets help. Down low on the forecheck from Rue. Rue turns it over, and it's going to be picked up by Yo, playing with speed to the left wing side. Oh, he's open in the neutral zone. They didn't recognize it right away. Nice touch pass across the line. To the forehand, another quick shot there by Bremer. Everett equal to the task. Back up through center ice they go. Here comes Rue with it. 3-on-3 across the line. Newhouse trying to find a pass to the slot area. Nothing doing there. Garcia's shot deflects and ramps up out of play and will face off inside the Pioneer zone. Neutral zone is looking very, very open now for the Pioneers throughout this contest.
Yeah, I think that's going to tighten up a little bit as we go, but very aggressive on the forechecks, and those first passes are getting out. But Hill Murray's defenseman is playing. They haven't had a lot of chances to defend, but when they have, their positioning is outstanding. There you see Bremer with that shot, but good squaring up to the shooter by the goaltender Everett. He's played really a very solid first period. Otherwise, we might be talking about a Hill Murray advantage, so he's kept them in this game until they get their legs about him.
Indeed he has. With 10:39 to go, we're scoreless. Thanks for joining us here tonight on Let's Play Hockey.com as the puck is controlled now by Helgeson. Helgeson winds it up, looks to play to the right wing side, instead gets a little bit of help along the way from Uner, who plays behind the net. Schweitzer there for the Red Knights, plays back in behind. McLeod will let that go as it's broken out by Dylan Hain. There's a shot to the slot area, pass rather. Oh, another chance. That's three quality opportunities now for Brock Bremer. You can see why he comes into this one leading the club in points.
The puck seems to look for him and finds him in most cases.
Or he certainly gets to it. He can really scoot. Not the biggest of frames, but understands the game. Plays this one from the low right circle. Shot in on goal there by Quast. And they look to try to break out, but once again it's gathered in by Tischler. He goes short side. Don't look now, but there's Bremer again. Tischler to the right point. Touch pass on the stick now for Sontag. His shot is deflected wide. McLeod was there. There's a puck that dribbles away. Moran was there as he's checked on the play. Very quick on the forecheck are the Pioneers right now, creating trouble for the Red Knights. Shot blocked by Moran. Look out. Here they come back out of the zone. Sims with it across the line. He'll hold and shoot. That one's deflected. Up and out of play. By the way, got to say hello to one of our viewers, Josh Sobsinski. By the way, that's at hmboyshockey.com. He's buddies with our boy Earnhardt, get this name, Earnhardt Jaworski. That's a real name.
Yeah, and there's a lot of different
names. Named after, great number three.
How about that? Yeah, in fact, we're probably going to see a little bit more. But Hilmer's really done a great job of possessing the puck in the offensive zone. Has been St. Margaret's defense chasing the play a little bit.
That pass is pushed through the goal mouth area and played back up through the center ice. On it now, it's Neubauer, one on three. He's going to try to carve. He can't. Jammed on the play, but they'll cycle back in behind the net for Quast. Now the Red Knights look to break out. Good support up the left wing boards as they'll get to center. On the puck there, that was Rue who lost the handle as the Pioneers close on that. Played back in. Off the boards by Arnold of the Red Knights. And now it's going to be Spindler for Benilde St. Margaret's. Quick touch pass through center. New. You got a piece of that one. We play on. Love it. 8:40 to go here in the first period. We're scoreless between the Red Knights and the Pioneers. Who would have thought that these two teams in recent history would be playing at this time of the year and neither one of them would be in the top 10 right now?
Well, it's a little bit unusual, but that's the beauty about high school hockey. It's a different edition every year.
You never know what you got, and you can't rest your laurels on the hefty 10-year contracts.
And to go cliche, it's not where you're ranked in December. It's where you're ranked
in March.
Oh,
thank you very much. It's
you're
not.
Welcome.
It's how you're playing. You can check that one off.
I forewarned everybody.
From the right corner, Quast plays it up high to the line. That's Boblitz. And now Clark takes over back behind the net. He gives over for Newhouse. Of course, his brother Ben, a member of the Union University edition.
Boy, he was a fine player, wasn't he?
Newhouse carves through the neutral. Loses the handle to the corner. Nice positioning by Uner there to force that one. There's a shot, short side, rebound! That one just wide. Now it'll be picked up by McNeil. Played up to the point for Clark. Quick wrist shot, dribbles through the goal mouth area. And the carom taken from the left wing side, played into center with Newhouse. Now he gives back over. It's Collins to play through. That's off the equipment in the hand there of Uner. And the Pioneers transition through the center ice area. Helgeson is there, brought down on the play as the Red Knights find an open wing. Sims, two on two, they cross at the line. Hain, shot, save, steered into the corner. Sims again, picked up on the carom by Sontag. Little sauce chucked up through center. Look out, here they come. In on goal, pad save Everett. He shuts the door on Helgeson. Bremer is there. Helgeson comes off the check with McNeil and down to make the play for the Red Knights is Moran. Hounded by Yo. Pushes the puck along for Schweitzer of the Red Knights. Yo gets in again and the puck is played up to the left wing wall. Crashing down from the point is Petronik. Keeps the line. Now it's up to the left point. There's a shot. Stick save again. To the left wing side. Sims cuts away from one man. Nice play there. Continues to work the dangle fest. That one's not going to work against the Red Knights. However, he picks up the loose puck back in behind the net. Sims with it. One of the captains of this edition for Arnold. Arnold plays off the boards to the corner. And Yo will take over from the end line there. Goes down on the play as he tries to help it along and look for Moyer. No relation to the big lefty, Jamie Moyer. Or you knew that one. It was coming what, through. Fastball at about 72.
Right, we'll check that one off the list.
Wow. Oh, there's so many on these two rosters, it's not even funny. You know, Garcia, I wanted to work the Jerry Garcia package, but we let that one lie, or did we?
Well, we'll see. Stay tuned.
Back into the corner it goes. Fleischacker is there, held in and sent wide. The Red Knights with some pressure here the past few minutes. Wind down to 5:42 to go in the first period. We are scoreless, and it's sent the length of the ice for an icing call.
Well, you're right, Pete. Actually, Benoit St. Margaret's starting to kind of get a little bit of a flow and offensive flavor about him. In fact, the last 2.5 minutes. But there you see Helgeson coming in, pretty good speed. Puck kind of danced on him a little bit, but look at the goaltender. Came out, challenged right outside the blue, deflected the rebound into the corner. So nice job once again by Zach Everett, the senior goaltender for the Red Knights.
If you could show us that again on another break, you don't have to, we'll let it go. But the one thing that I really liked there, Bart, was McNeil didn't get much of an angle to disrupt what Helgeson was doing because he trusted his skating ability and his speed, and he just beelined it straight to the net and created that chance. And, you know, Everett's been very good in goal for the Red Knights so far. And equally, Begley has, too, as he's had some deflections.
Well, I just think that if Ken Pauley said five minutes ago in the first period, tied 0-0 and getting some offensive chances, I think he'd be pretty happy with that.
That one's played up to the left-wing side. Here come the Pioneers. They'll swing it to the right with Quast. Stood up on the play. Newhouse. And over they come. Big check thrown to the corner there by Jablonski. He'll take over the loose change to the corner. Checked on the play, and Newhouse will take over. McNeil. Nice job picking that up on stride was Collins. Across the line he goes. McNeil now on it. Bothered in the corner by the Pioneers. That's Quast. And guiding it out of the zone, it's Derek Breezy, the defenseman, the big frame. From the checker, plays that one in behind. Everett's going to let it go and allow his man to peel this off the wall, and Clark. Clark's going to get a little help along the boards. Real muddy there, right in front of you from the St. Louis Park Rec Center. Stood up at the line. The Pioneers will win the battle, play it deep. Knapp tries to find the bounding puck. Sims is going to play it back right into the belly of the beast. Oh, it rides a dasher, gets away from everybody. And quick on that puck, it's Baublitz. Now Sims down low will gather it out. He's got Moran streaking on the tape. Here comes Moran across the line, one on two, waiting for help. Works the escape right into the official. Part of the game, folks. Sims is there. Moran, he'll handle now. Checked on the play. He's watched closely by Oberle. And it's a two-on-two battle right behind Begley. And it's going to be gathered up and out of the zone by Uner. Through center, here comes a foot race. Arnold gets the angle, turns away from trouble, sits on it. Plays that one behind McLeod, who comes away with the puck for the red and white of Benoit St. Margaret's. Bremer takes over, finds his man. Nice pass, in on goal. Helgeson, a shot and a save. Gets the arm extended. Everett's been rock solid here tonight.
Well, that's got to give his team a little bit of confidence there. They're not afraid to make a mistake, and Lord knows they've made a couple of them, but he's been there to pick them up. Very important in a team that's struggling offensively.
Angles have been squared. His rebound control has been good enough, and we're still scoreless under 3 minutes to go in the first. Across the line, the skating machine known as Ben Helgeson, 2 goals, 2 assists on the season, gets his own puck back and plays it back in. Another number 14, Nate Schweitzer, comes away with the puck. Plays that back up to the right wing side. Looking to make the play was Barr. Yo, turn, shoot, save, rebound. Everett was there. Puck rolls toward the goal mouth area. Nothing doing there as the Red Knights will carry it back out of the zone. On the puck, it's Stefan Garcia. To the right wing side, Rue stopped on the play. Nice job there. Petronik has it. Back up through the center ice area. Newhouse winds up back in behind his net. He'll counter back up to the right wing side. Nearly turned over. Yo got the stick on that one. Instead, the Pioneers will go Pez dispenser and fire it right back in.
Well, there you see. Really a nice job of actually covering. That's Brian Arnold, the senior defender. A nice tag team. But Benilda's challenging at the blue line, forcing Hill Murray to make a decision. But there you see. And that's Helgeson coming in. But again, a square, the goaltender squared. That was the one that you wanted. But
yeah, I was just kind of getting down to the fact that he didn't turn his shoulder in. He just kept going straight ahead. And he liked his line to the net, was not deterred by McNeil coming over and,
right,
and forced the play. I appreciated that offensively.
Absolutely. And then after that, Everett made another big save. So he's really done a great job. Just under 2 minutes ago in this first period, we're still not at 0-0, but the play's starting to go up and down now.
It's. I'll tell you what, it's more open than I expected coming into this one, Bart.
I don't disagree.
A treat of a period. McNeil with it. Now Newhouse plays this one on the tape that rolls off the stick of Joe Collins. And they'll regroup back in their own zone. 1:35 to go here in the first period with McNeil. Guides ahead. Jablonski with it. Sweater number three. And offside on the left wing side. It looked like it was Joe Collins, I think, got in a little ahead of the play.
Yeah, it was David Quass that actually stepped up and challenged at that point. But there you see that shot by Helgeson. But again, another good save by Everett. But nice challenge at the blue line as Hill Murray's done, pretty much for this whole first period, forcing Benel St. Margaret's to make that decision. And there you get a look at it again. That's Ben Helgeson. He's one of the primary offensive players on this team. So that just shows what a big save that was for Everett. Picked up his team again.
Rock solid. Keeps it scoreless. Arnold with it. Scoring chances by far are going to be outweighing the Pioneers at least 3-1, I would say, at this juncture of the first period.
Yeah, at least a quality scoring chance.
Absolutely.
Sure.
Back into the right wing side it goes. Moran with it across the line. Drop pass for Hain. Traffic save. Big save there. Nice job by Begley to extend the right pillow. Now it's Spindler regrouping in his own zone from left to right to Arnold. Places it back into center ice. Hain will get it back to Arnold. They find Moran off his skates. Nope. And icing the call.
Well, actually, that was a pretty good sequence by the Red Knights. In fact, the shot from the defender was a nice shot, low shot, a lot of traffic in front of Bagley. But again, Hill Murray did a good job of protecting the goaltender. Oh, boy, looking forward to that Holiday Classic.
Look at Bart Archer wiping the drool off his mouth.
I mean, it's absolutely
amazing. Not only are you in your home turf of Braemar Arena in Edina.
My nookie blanket.
But you get your second favorite team in the world. The Grand Rapids Thunderhawks.
Love the Thunderhawks.
Followed by your third favorite team, and don't take it offensively, Smith, the Eden Prairie Eagles. Followed by your fourth favorite team, Elk River. You got top ten teams all over the place.
It's like Christmas is coming early for
Bart. Oh, yeah. Rebound. Oh, what a save down low on Yo. He had a great opportunity, but Everett was there. Low slot area, fanned on there by Breezy. They keep it alive. Bremer shoots. That's blocked off the shin pads. Gets a little dicey in the Red Knight zone. They can't clear it. Now it's going to be played down low. Yo, touch, scores! Oh, a touch pass over to Bremer. What a play. And they let the gals in the Red Knight sweaters know it back behind the bench.
Wow. But that was really a nice sequence by the Hill Murray Pioneers. Started with Yo along the right wing wall over to Helgeson and then a redirect in. But that was, I believe, Brock Bremer, who we called his name quite a few times tonight. That's his third goal of the year. But nice tic-tac-toe play by Hill Murray in the waning moments of this first period to give him a little energy going into the locker room. Not a lot of time left, but Benel St. Margaret's could certainly answer.
It all resulted in the inability to clear the zone after it looked like they had it, and that's something I'm sure Coach Paulie Russo and company are going to talk about.
Boy,
there's a chance there.
Right
that
there.
There was your answer right there, Barb. But back they come out of the zone. On and it's Uner. He's checked by Moran. Hain with it for Sims. Sliding over to make the play now. It's Nath. That one gets away, and that'll do it. Big goal late in the first period here for the Hill Murray Pioneers. Gives them a 1-0 lead after one in a period which saw some ebbs and flows and backs and back and forth, but really the story has been the play of Everett and goal so far.
Yeah, indeed it has, and it just seemed like in that last sequence by the Pioneers, they're very aggressive on the forecheck, covered a lot of space, but it just seemed like Benel St. Margaret's kind of lost their composure a little bit, started to chase the play again, and they couldn't catch up with that puck, but that's where we sit 1-0. But it was a good period. It was a little more, as you said, wide open than we thought it would be, and I think it's going to continue to do that, but I think Benel St. Margaret's is going to settle down. Coach Paulie's going to get them refocused, but I look forward to a great second period.
Indeed we do. The score is 1-0 in favor of the Pioneers. We're going to take a timeout. High school hockey continues from the St. Louis Park Rec Center on letsplayhockey.com. We are between periods of the Let's Play Hockey Game of the Week, and we're joined by True Hockey's Jason Kasouris. You are a part of a company that is a growing hockey equipment manufacturer, and you have some great stuff. Jason, can you tell us a little bit about your company and how it's growing?
Well, essentially, we've been in the hockey market for a very long time, actually, close to 16 years. But we haven't been branded as True. We've been building hockey sticks for multiple other manufacturers, pretty much any of the manufacturers that are out today and have actually come and gone. But we've been building their sticks, just labeling them with their logos and everything like that. But about 3 years ago, we decided, hey, let's build our own brand. Let's stop making for others and really be innovative. We want to bring products to the market that still stay traditional to the hockey consumer, but with added perks, with added technology that's going to improve the products. improve the player. So with that, you know, we've kept in the sticks. We've now introduced a glove line in our Z Palm offerings that you can change out the palms to increase performance, but also change the durability aspects. I mean, there's multiple different things that you can look at with our gloves. We will be introducing pants in 2017. Just as a growth aspect, we just recently last week announced the purchase of VH Footwear. So we are getting into skates. We're growing the brand as much as we possibly can, but we're doing it strategically. It's not where we're just bringing everything all at once and trying to flood the market with all of our equipment. We want to be innovative. That's our biggest thing. We want to be a high end company that looks at ways to make a player better, make our products better, not just be a me too company.
Well, and I think the important component is that you were the technology behind a lot of the quote brand name sticks. But now you are the brand and the technology, and I think that's important for the consumer to know. And then the second aspect is the innovation of your products from the palms. I mean, I know as a hockey parent, one of the most frustrating things is you buy a kid a pair of gloves, and within a year they're worn out because the knob is just taken out one of the hands, and you got to start over again. But you have a solution to that, which can allow you to keep those gloves, and you just replace the palms, correct?
Correct. And like I said, you know, it can be treated, I look at it as three different ways. So with that palm completely zipping out, you can look at it as a durability aspect. So a year down the road, the top hand blows out or anything like that. You can just go in. You don't have to buy a new pair of gloves. You don't have to take it into a repair shop and get a completely different feel to the glove or anything like that. It's just a matter of going into your local dealer that has the palm offerings and change it out, and you have the exact same feeling glove and just go from there. The other aspect is we have five different options in palms. So we have all different performance aspects. We have a durable palm in our Z Power. We have our standard is a great palm as well. We have our Z Fit that is a very, very soft feeling, very thin feeling. We have a Z Pro that a lot of players, it's a very thin, ultra feel palm. And then we have our Z Grip, which is a tackified grip that really helps with the grip of the stick. So that's another attribute. The third attribute is the dryability of the gloves. A lot of the issues with gloves is they stink, quite honestly. Mm-hmm. And, you know, to get any sprays into a glove or anything like that, you can't really get into the fingertips of a glove to kill any of that bacteria. So now what you can actually do is you can unzip that palm and take it off, spray the whole glove down, and then dry it out. And it works unbelievably great.
That's amazing stuff. It is.
I mean, it is. And the other nice thing, too, is, you know, I use the example as I played in a pond hockey tournament last winter. I used these gloves. It was 45 degrees out, so it was extremely warm. We were essentially skating in puddles.
Swimming, yeah.
And the gloves got extremely wet in the one game, and I had another game that I had to go to in 15 minutes. So I just zipped out the palm. Put a new palm in, dry gloves, ready to go. So, I mean, it definitely works for, you know, what it's intended to, and it improves the playability of the gloves. It also improves the overall performance of the gloves for the players.
You can find their information at true-hockey.com, and you can also get it in local stores. Jason, if you wouldn't mind, outline to us where we can find your product in stores in the Twin Cities area.
Twin Cities area, Hockey Central and Blaine, Dave's Sports Shops, Strauss, General Sports, just to name a few, Total Hockey's as well. We're definitely growing brand and we're building that dealer base as much as possible. Even if you can't find it at any of the dealers, more than likely we've had contact with them, and they should be able to order something from us. So.
And it won't hurt to ask for True Hockey brands, too, at your local dealer if they're not there. You can also purchase your product online, too. Is that correct, at various online sporting good hockey stores as well?
Correct. We're in all the major online dealers as well.
Perfect. Jason, thank you so much. And once again, that is true-hockey.com. We're going to take a quick time out. We're going to return back to high school hockey action of the Let's Play Hockey Game of the Week. We are between periods of the Let's Play Hockey.com Game of the Week, and we are pleased to be joined by Kelly Meza, the owner of Goodwood Hockey, and she has a great product. Kelly, thanks for joining us between periods here today. And can you tell us a little bit about your company? I know it's an apparel company, but how did it all get started?
Sure. Thanks for having me. Actually, we just started, and it was a quick start. Last year at about this time, I was just having a really difficult time finding hockey-related apparel for my kids for Christmas, and in passing, my husband kind of offered up the suggestion that I should start my own company. And at the time, I was a medical consultant for a pharmaceutical company, thought it might be a good side business, and the stars kind of aligned. I left the company that I'd worked for many years and started this full-time just the summer of 2016, so we're just a few months old.
And how's it been going for you? You've got a really unique product line, which I like, is different from anything else I've seen.
So thanks so much for that, and it's going really well, and I think that where we're different, there's a lot of great Minnesota-based hockey apparel companies out there, but I think the direction and the focus that I'd like to head is for the whole family and for the whole country, and actually even expanding maybe into Canada or Europe in the future. But instead of just focusing on adult wear or men's wear, we have a line just for girls that are similar designs to any kind of gender-neutral design, but with a more feminine cut garment. We focused on trying to source all of our garments from U.S. manufacturers whenever possible. And so we have something for everybody, whether you are a hockey player or a hockey fan. We have items, clothing, and accessories for just about anybody who loves hockey.
And we're talking at the individual and team level too, correct?
So right now we do individual levels, although we have provided the same shirt for all the team members on certain teams if they request that. We don't do team-specific wear at this time, but that doesn't mean we're not open to that in the future.
Your website is goodwoodhockey.com. I'm looking at it right now in your holiday shop 2016. You've got everything from tees to long-sleeve tees, to great baseball hats, to winter caps, to everything. So do you have particular large sellers? You also have baby apparel too, which you don't see much of.
We do. We just started with our baby apparel. We have several styles that are start at a 2T, and that includes a Zamboni or an ice cleaner design that's actually hand-sketched by a Florida-based artist.
And it's really impressive.
And then transferred it to
it's
a
cool
garment. Thank you. She actually drew that with a pencil. And then
wow,
for the holiday shirt, we branched into infant sizes, starting as little as 3 to 6 months. It's had a great response, and we look forward to providing more options as we move along here.
No, seriously, on that Zamboni shirt, and this is part of what's unique about what you do. Little kids love the Zamboni. I was one of them. If I were a little guy and was a girl and able to get that shirt, I would wear it religiously. You got to check it out on goodwoodhockey.com. Click shop, and I think that's just an automatic, natural gift. You've got a lot of really good looking stuff on here. So
thanks so much.
A lot
of those styles have matching big people versions as well. So there's a big version of the ice cleaner for dads or moms or big brothers or sisters as well.
Well, it's a fascinating piece for sure. So,
is
there any other way to get a hold of you from a shopping perspective, or is it the best way to go on goodwoodhockey.com?
The best way to go is goodwoodhockey.com. We were fortunate to be a part of the Holiday Boutique at U.S. Bank Stadium a few weeks ago, and we will happily be a vendor at the Let's Play Hockey Expo this spring. And online is the best way to get me, and I am a direct line by email at service@goodwoodhockey.com. You get me personally at that email, that's service@goodwoodhockey.com. And we're also available on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Goodwood Hockey.
Kelly, thank you very much. That's goodwoodhockey.com. We'll return to the rink with more action of the Let's Play Hockey Game of the Week. And we welcome you back to the St. Louis Park Rec Center, where the Hilmer Pioneers take a late first period lead and lead by a score of 1-0. That goal scored with 24 seconds left on the clock. And, you know, one that was a reward from some hard work and some great scoring chances.
Oh, absolutely. In fact, it was Crocodile Brock Bremer that scored his third goal of the season from Helgeson and Neal at 16:36. As you said, 24 seconds left. But that was a reward for a lot of hard work from those Hill Murray forwards. On the forecheck, they were on the puck. They were really on the defenseman of the Benilde-St. Margaret Red Knights, and they just kind of forced them into an area where they had to kind of force the play a little bit, but they got rewarded for a lot of hard work. But really, the effort from Zach Everett, the Red Knight goaltender, I think was the story of that period. I think without his contributions, it could be a 3-4 goal advantage for Hill Murray. So he did a great job of keeping his team within striking distance. Benilde-St. Margaret's one good shot away from tying this game up, but that's very impressive the way Hill Murray not only started the game, had a little bit of lull in the middle part, but they finished very, very strong. But the Red Knights showed some offensive wherewithal, and I think that's kind of a relief, and it really kind of made people settle in a little bit to watch a good two-way hockey game.
I think the one thing that's going to be worth developing and discussing is the pace and the tempo of the Hill Murray Pioneers, if it's going to continue to wear down the Red Knights and their turnover ratio. There were a lot of those in the first period, and I think it's significant enough to take a look at and say, you know what? This is where a game can be trouble as you get later on into the later stages of this period and into the third. But with that said, the Red Knights, you know, they're only down one goal and they have the ability to adjust.
Yeah, the challenge in front of the Red Knights is they've given up 5 second period goals and 5 third period goals, and that is just in 3 games. So obviously, points of concern as far as that goes. Hill Murray gets better as the game goes on. It seems like Benilde-St. Margaret's wheels start to wobble a little bit, but I'm sure Coach Ken Pauley has them refocused, rededicated, and I think we're going to see a good up and down second period.
For the Red Knights, Nate Clark led his team in blocked shots with 2. They had 6 for the first period to 1 for the Pioneers. Hill Murray in their green, white, and black sweaters will be moving from left to right across your computer screen, but hey, now you're going with the smart TVs too. So across your TV screen in high definition right here on letsplayhockey.com via our YouTube channel. Thanks for joining us here tonight. As the Red Knights look to break out through center, they do. Moran is there with the puck. It's sent through the goal mouth area. McLeod will walk down to play back in behind the net. Sims is pinned up on the boards by Sontag. Yo in there to help out. A little more help for the Red Knights. That's Hain helping out. The two-on-two battle, they look to keep the puck moving indeed. And now Yo comes in to take over, muscles off his man. That was Dylan Hain bothering him. And in to help out down low now, it's Petronik. Yo. From the center ice area, it's sent back in, but Yo comes right up on that one and plays it back through. As McLeod will regroup, the forwards will change for the Pioneers. And a whistle on the play. They're going to say too many.
Yeah, kind of a muddy line change on that one, but we're going to get an advantage, and it looks like it's going to be Benilde-St. Margaret's. It's going to be a flag for the too many men on the ice penalty as it stands, so Hill Murray again gets another shot on the power play, and I don't know who's going to serve, but I want to just make mention of Nate Schweitzer, just a freshman out there playing defense for the Red Knight squad, did a nice job of actually taking the attacking player and using his body to defend and separating him from the puck. So very grizzled play by the young freshman. But now Benilde-St. Margaret's going to have to kill off another penalty. And if the penalty is on Benilde, yep, faceoff in the Benilde zone, but faceoff is going to be very important during this special teams.
Second power play now for the Pioneers. They're 0 for 1 in the evening. Shot in on goal as that's deflected right into the midsection of Everett. Bidding there for the Pioneers was Anthony Betty.
Well, it was a pretty good shot on goal. Actually, a little higher than I think that he wanted, but nice job by Everett tracking that puck through traffic, holding onto a faceoff to his right. 1:52 left in the power play for Hill Murray.
And the Pioneers contain again, left wing side. Sontag plays over to the right. Gets it back up high, one of the captains of this edition. He plays catch with Petronik. There's a shot that's wide of the net. Picked up out of the corner. Played back up to Petronik. Looks over to Sontag, looks him off. There's a shot that doesn't get through as I believe that hit the defense of Newhouse in front. Nice job to pinch that one off into the neutral zone by Petronik. They play it to the left wing side. It's Sontag to ring the wall. One-handed up to the line. Nice little play there by the winger for the Pioneers on that play. That was Nath. Now from the right side, they're going to play over to the left. Yo with it from the left wing hash. Back up Petronik. Up high they go. That one's deflected wide of the net. Newhouse will ring the wall. Ooh, look out. They might have had too many the other way there. Well, as it's sent right back in.
Hill Murray's mindset is a good low shots from the point and make them tippable. I don't think they're confident that they can get the puck through to the goaltender Everett, so they're just going for the deflections. I think that's a pretty good strategy the way Benilde's defending.
Bremer flies through the neutral zone, angles from right to left, bothered on the play by Hain, pinched off by McLeod. From the corner, they look to work it to the goal mouth. There he scores! That's Bremer. Yeah. Wow. Mr. Opportunistic takes a nice pass from the goal mouth area. And it's 2-0 Hill Murray.
Yeah, and I think that was Neubauer that actually set that play up. He'll start from behind the goal and send it out. And it was a one-time shot by Crocodile Brock Bremer with the second goal of the game, his fourth of the season. But kind of a tic-tac-toe play. Benilde St. Margaret's just kind of watching and standing still on that one. But nice puck movement by Hill Murray. Now it's a 2-1 advantage. We're back to 5-on-5. And here's the work down low. You'll see him just grab it. Not a lot of opportunities right there, so he dished it off, and it was a nice job by Bremer to deposit that into the open net, and that was blocker side, just about 2.5 feet off the ice, so really a nice shot.
2-on-1 is always a good number, and they had that on that puck out of the corner, and Bremer went to an area where there was a stick on him, and he was able to find an opening and send that one home.
But really nice play by Neubauer to actually make that play happen the way that it did.
The Pioneers now with a couple of goals to open up the 2-0 lead. One late in the first, one here early in the second. Deflected back through by the Pioneers. That's Anthony Hurley. Takes the body down low to the corner. Moyer is there to help out. On the forecheck, Fleischacker was there. And it comes back into the Pioneer zone as they guide that one up through the bench area. And look out, nice positioning there and a whistle on the play. And we have an interference call. Here's a look at that goal one more time. Almost had an opportunity to clear it there, did the Red Knight Spindler.
Well, and I think positioning could have been a little bit better by Benilde St. Margaret's. Take that passing lane away, but that's going to be David Quas, a senior defenseman for Hill Murray. Interference penalty. Now Benilde St. Margaret's with that 9.1 power play percentage gets a chance to actually cut the deficit to one. Penalty kill for Hill Murray is hovering around the 85% mark, 86% mark, which is pretty much business as usual for Lechner coach squad.
No doubt. And, you know, this is an area for the Red Knights that over the years has been so effective and just deadly. Sims to the corner, up high now for McLeod to Newhouse on the right wing side. Around the boards they go. Sims gathers in as it's duel that out of the corner and swatted up and out of play by Will Sontag, and we'll face off inside the zone again.
Well, I think one of the things that Benilde St. Margaret's has to focus on is getting the puck between the dots. They're very good on the periphery. They're very good side to side as far as their defensemen, but they have to get into the prime real estate and get some pressure on Jake Begley, the senior goaltender for the Pioneers. On the power play, they should have the opportunity to do that, but they have to get it into the slot area. That's the ultimate goal, get the shots on goal.
Right now the Red Knight power play clicks at 9%, yep, 9% rate, 1 for 11. McLeod, ooh, ooh. Oohs and ahs even from up here. They say that's good. Down low it goes. Swung up to the wall. McLeod will hold it. Sims is there to help him out, but Bremer too busy. Looked like Sims lost his stick and wanted to know how that happened, but doesn't matter.
We play on.
Absolutely. Back in behind the red knight net it goes. That's Newhouse. Outlets to McLeod. Gets away from one man. Goes to the right wing side. Too far for Sims. And to pick up the loose puck and send it the length of the ice was Joey Petronik.
See, those are the things that are kind of hurting the Red Knights, as they had numbers and speed through the neutral zone, but just misfired on that pass all the way down. Burned some time. 1 minute and 3 seconds left on the penalty to David Quast.
And it's going to be Hain across the line. Moran leaves for McLeod. McLeod snapper in on the glove hand there of the goaltender, Jake Begley. He'll hold on. The 54 to go on the man advantage.
Yeah, Bronson McLeod did a nice job of actually reading the play and kind of did a little drag to try to change the angle on that. Pretty good shot on goal. Not a challenging save for Begley. He tracked that one quite well, face off to his right. Just 54 seconds left in the Pioneer penalty. But pretty good shot on goal by Bonneau. But again, they have to get tighter and get a little bit more velocity on their shots. More of a challenge for the goaltender.
Turn back up to the right wing side. It's Collins. He'll hold it. Deflects up high. Collins, top of the left circle, loses the handle. He'll regroup. Plays it rink wide. Clark wanted. Ooh, look out. They lost the handle. Back to center it goes. Clark with it. Working with Spindler. Instead, they'll move further south, if you will. Racing up the right wing side through center. That's Schweitzer. Checked in the corner. Back up to the point. Spindler with it. Snapshot. Traffic deflects wide. Clark comes over. The Pioneers look to play it out of the zone, and they do. On that play, it was Breezy. Now it's Spindler with it. Bumps the wall for Clark. Clark looks ahead as the Pioneers kill off the penalty. 0 for 1 in the evening are the Red Knights. Ooh, just... Okay. That one and on goal. Steered aside.
It's not the first one.
We'll let her go. Play on. Arnold with it now to the corner. Oh, back door. There's an opportunity. Collins had Schweitzer, who swatted at that one backhand, and that missed the mark.
Yeah, didn't miss by much.
Played back up in the center. Clark better hurry. He has pressure. Plays it over the near side. This is kind of the closing opportunity that the Pioneers have that force quick decisions that the Red Knights don't look comfortable in. That one steered back in behind the net. Barr will take the rolling puck from the right wing side. He has Garcia on the move. Across the line, Garcia wanted a drop pass, but the coverage too good by the Pioneers.
Well, and he had space in front of him too, so a little bit too unselfish on that
Ooh,
play.
McLeod makes the play at the line. Bounding puck behind the net. Rue is there. Garcia tries to open up in the right circle, but the defensive zone coverage really airtight by the Pioneers of Hill Murray. It's as good as we've seen here so far this year. Played rink wide back into the corner. Behind the net it goes. At center, it's Newhouse playing over for McLeod. He'll play back in behind. Begley's going to cut that one off behind the net. Check thrown on the defense there as Petronik was there to guide it up to the left wing boards, but Barr pinches down. Betty clears the zone. It'll trickle its way back in wide of the net. And icing the call with 10:33 to go in the second period.
Well, Pete, you talked about Hill Murray's defense. Very smothering, but positionally they're very sound. They really make you use the whole rink to try to get that opportunity. But, again, going back, hearkening back to what we talked about before, that power play was generally on the periphery. They didn't get too many shots or the puck into that scoring area. So I credit that more a success for Hill Murray than a detriment for Benilde St. Margaret's. The effort was indeed there, but Hill Murray's defense was just too smothering.
That attempt was thwarted there by the Pioneer defense. That was Sontag out front, but Sims will chase down the loose puck. Plays it to the goal mouth area, swatted again away. The Pioneers will take over. They look up ice. This Pioneer team isn't flashy, but they're very, very positionally sound, and they've got the skill to go along with the knowledge. I like how this team looks, Bart. They're going to be a problem this year, you can tell.
It's a team that skates very well, and they work their edges very hard. Very difficult to defend against.
Strong on the puck, indeed. Out of the zone come the Red Knights with it. That's Hain. Goes to the left wing side for Sims. He runs into a check. The old how's she going shiver from Sontag. Sims loses the handle. Sliding over to make the play was Hain. As the Pioneers look to play to center. That gets away from the stick of Tischler. In to gather in the loose change is Neubauer. That one's turned to the corner.
Well, that was a pretty good save by Everett on Neubauer. That was a kind of an owly little shot, but he directed it in the corner. Nice job by Everett once again.
Owly little shot, kind of like Bart Archer every morning when he doesn't get his cup of coffee. Pioneers control off the bench. It's Yo taking that one over. As his pass was deflected, gets it back, shoots. Oh, a glove save and a beauty. Wow, flaring it there was Everett. Nice save.
Yeah, and there was some traffic in front. It was Ben Helgeson that was actually in front disrupting things, but Yo did a nice job of circling into the area, getting a better angle on that shot. Firing it about two feet off the ice, but really a nice glove save once again by Zach Everett. We've said his name an awful lot tonight. But look at Yo. He identifies the situation. He's got a good clear line, but you can see Helgeson trying to interrupt the sightlines for Everett. Did a pretty good job, so even a better save on that replay than it was initially.
It looked like he saw it at the last second. The rebound off the end boards is gathered in but doesn't hit the mark, and it's going to be taken over off the left side by Collins and plays into the neutral, but sent right back in by the Pioneers. Turning back at Schweitzer from his own zone to the right wing. Off the stick there of McNeil. And the Pioneers close and play the body. Picked off at center. Here comes Bremer. Oh, and he zings that one over the top of the goal. Jablonski was there. Body check thrown again. Puck rolls into the center ice area. Breezy will play that around hard. Schweitzer looks to play ahead to McNeil. As he tries to find it out of the zone. Down on the play they go. There's a puck that's taken over. Nice play there off the glass by Schweitzer. They can't get the zone, though, as the Pioneers continue to buzz. Cycled back in behind the net by Helgeson. Taken away by Bremer. He stood up on the play. Boy, he didn't go down. Very impressive there.
Big check by Jablonski, though. That was a play-stopping check, so it didn't look great, but it was very effective.
Oh, stunning to say the least. Little pass thrown over there for Nath from Bremer, but that's picked off by the Red Knights and controlled again by the Pioneers of Hill Murray. They're going to play that one back into Red Knight territory. This is kind of a hot potato right now. Who wants the puck? It doesn't look like anybody. No icing on the play. Back behind the net, Breezy. Oh, they had a man down low, and Rue, his stick lifted, couldn't make the play. Nice job there by the Pioneers. From the left wing side, Garcia tries to battle for the puck. Turned over and handled now by Barr. Barr will play back in behind the net. And the puck is played back in the length of the ice. No icing the call, as it's going to be Clark who plays for Newhouse. Newhouse will gather in on the rolling puck, comes away from traffic. Nice control there. Picked off at center, Petronik. And that one's just offside.
Boy, Bernard St. Marcus is a little vulnerable on that one, but there you're going to see the Yo shot again. But again, that Everett save, you can't see that one enough. That was actually very impressive. But this is kind of getting back to the goal, and that's Neubauer, I believe, getting that out to Bremer, and that's the second goal of the game. And that's
in case you missed
right
it.
Now. In case you missed it. Nice job by Brett Michaels to round that one back up and do a quick review.
Every cowboy sings a sad, sad song.
And every rose has a thorn.
That's right.
Oh.
Wow. Turned over at the line. Of course, he's had the big dating show. Rebound, they score! 3-0, Pioneers down low they go. And a big goal scored there as they create some more space in this game. I believe that was Moyer who slapped that one home.
Well, it was either Moyer or Fleischacker on that one. Hard to tell, but again, another breakdown in the Benilde St. Margaret zone. Just an errant pass, really gained possession. Then you see Benilde trying to kind of gather their positioning again. Nice save by Everett, but that rebound on a Doyle. And I believe that was Mike Fleischacker with his first goal of this season, but we'll wait for the official scoring.
Kind of tough to even tell from here as the puck was kind of rolling around and bounding around.
Yeah, 15. Being in the right place at the right time.
They gave it to Moyer officially. So officially Moyer from Fleischacker.
We'll wait for the adjustment on that one, but
we'll leave that to the official scorer here right for the Red Knights. Of course, nobody better than the man known as House, Craig Roberts. So 3-0 the score with under 6.5 to go in the second period. The Pioneers have taken control of this contest, and they're getting better as this game is moving on. Nice little play out of the phone booth there. Quast picked off along the way. Up the ice they go for the Red Knights with Peter Moran. 3 goals on the season. Leaves off for Sims. Sims forgot something out of the corner there. And now it's picked up by the Pioneers of Hill Murray. Off the boards they go. Puck is bumped off the boards, batted down by Hain, and they're going to change on the fly as it's sent back into the corner. Handled now on the breakout by Sontag. He's jammed. Oh. Whistle on the play. Sontag was absolutely crushed.
Well, it looks like that's actually Joe Quast on that one, number 24. No worries, but it was Hain, actually, Dylan Hain, that took him against the boards. I will wait for the official call as far as what that is, but Hill Murray back on the power play. This is really not a penalty that Benoit St. Margaret's needed to take at this juncture. Already being scored on twice this period, one on the power play. Putting Hill Murray back on the power play again is not really the recipe for success, but it just seems like Benoit has a propensity to start chasing the play and losing their positional integrity. But either that or it's just one miscue and then things kind of unravel. That's something that Coach Pauly has a wherewithal to be able to correct. It might take a little bit of time, but they just have to keep moving in the right direction. But now the challenge is in front of him to kill off this penalty. It's a 5-minute penalty.
It's 5 minutes for head contact to Dylan Hain. So this Pioneer power play can go to work for 5 minutes, pretty much the duration of the period, as it's going to be Breezy. Bremer now somehow works the line, plays it deep, back in behind. Garcia's there, finds an opening, and rips it the length of the ice as it's going to be Begley to set up back behind his own net.
Well, one thing, when you get a 5-minute major penalty, you still have to play defense. Benoit St. Margaret's is a team, they scoring goals has been a challenge this year, but they've always had a propensity to be able to put some offensive pressure, a man down.
They carry this one down to the corner. Helgeson is there, gives up for Yo. Now Yo finds his man and Breezy back to Yo. Little touch pass for Bremer, fails to click. Back up high they go. Snaps, that one's deflected wide by Everett. And back behind the net, McNeil was there, and they find another opening and send it the length of the ice.
You know, we're about a minute and 5 seconds into this power play for Hill Murray, and Benoit St. Margaret's done a really good job of defending. They're pressuring, they're getting on them quick, taking their time and space away, and that's ideally what you want. Burn the time.
By the way, really a great outdoor rink they built here with the piping and the whole deal here at St. Louis Park at the Rec Center. They got rid of the skateboard park. Not completely. I believe they moved that on to another area. But it is absolutely a phenomenal facility. Moran with it. Ooh, a little toe drag to the backhand. Couldn't pull the trigger. Working the skills. Petronik there. Where's the Turcotte stick handling school when you need it?
The Ulf Dahlin.
Oh, that's the phone booth for him.
There you go.
Off the boards.
That was a really nice job by Peter Nath Moran
with
to
it.
Burn some time.
We're down to 3:09 to go in the major. The Red Knights can't clear as that's into the equipment of Sontag. Puck will be swung around to the boards. Look to find an opening. They can't get it. And regrouping in his own zone, it's Sontag. Across center, rung hard in. Everett doesn't get all of it. Schweitzer was there. He didn't either. Now Jablonski helps out. McLeod was there. Up high they go. On it, that's Petronik. Shot that's blocked doesn't get through by Breezy. To the corner, it's Baublitz. And the opening is found by the Red Knights as they clear again. So far, they're winning the battles and finding the openings.
That's exactly what I was going to say. They're starting to win the battles to the loose puck and actually winning the one-on-one battles and icing the puck down. Just 2:23 left in the major penalty to Dylan Hain. But, again, it's more the defense of Benoit St. Margaret's than the lack of opportunities by the Pioneers. So Benoit's doing a great job of killing this penalty so far.
Offside on that stretch pass for the Pioneers, so we'll face off outside the Red Knight zone. Yo and Sims. Yo pulls it back. I don't know if Sims really swatted it ahead, either or. The Pioneers control, and Breezy has it. Garcia takes that turnover from the neutral, 2-on-2. Garcia runs out of real estate. Well, why not just throw that one in on goal? You're shorthanded. And it's picked up by the Pioneers.
Well, I think you want to do a regroup, get it back to the defense, and then pull it back in and then dump it in. But Hillmurray's position's just been too solid all night.
They have been really good indeed. This penalty kill has been rock solid for the Red Knights of Benilde St. Margaret's as well. That one is deflected up as it flutters in the air. And now Yo will regroup and take control off the boards. It goes and back into Red Knight territory. They'll converge back in behind the net as it's Newhouse for Sims. We'll have to try to catch up, but getting there first is Breezy. Red Knights looked to clear but not out. Nice job up the boards by Sims to push that into the neutral zone. And it's going to be Neubauer to take over. Now Bremer looks up ice. Whips across to the right wing side. A very frenetic pace that he plays with, does Bremer. So Red Knights clear the zone.
Yeah, he tried to draw the defenders in, dish it back, but good position by Benilde St. Margaret's, interrupted that pass, sent it down. Just over a minute to go on this major penalty to Benilde. They've done a great job so far. They got a minute to go.
At the line, picked up by McLeod, who swats that one off the boards. Begley will clear off to his right behind the net. Now there's portions of this Pioneer zone that does not even need any Zamboni work. I'm looking in the right circle there. No need for the patented St. Louis Park Rec Center victory lap.
Right. Well, that's what happened when you take a couple penalties against a team like Hill Murray.
1:20 to go in the period. 33 to go in the power play. 5-minute major. As the Pioneers once again through center with Nath. Plays to the right wing. That's going to be handled by Betty. Quick wrist shot. They score! That one from Sontag is deflected down low, and it's 4-0 Hill Murray here in the second period.
Yeah, and I think it was Emmett Nath that actually redirected that one. That'd be his third goal of the year if that's indeed what happened. But Sontag, we've said his name so many times tonight, really a driving force for this Hill Murray, especially in the power play. He's the quarterback back there, but good vision on that one. Just a quick fire, didn't take the big slap shot, and just a nice redirect, and I think that was Emmett Nath that's going to get credit for that goal. Just 16 seconds left. Boy, they came dangerously close to killing that one off. But now it's 4-0. Obviously, Benilde St. Margaret's has a steep hill to climb.
And a quick faceoff win and a shot buzzed wide of the net by Fleischacker. And the big carom to the center ice area for Moran. He's stopped at the line, leaves over for Arnold, and it's going to be picked up by Moyer. Right wing side, there you go. Now we're at full strength, 5-on-5 hockey with 40 to go in the period. Moyer bothered on the play. A little bit of help down low with Hurley. And Moran will give it off as they work out of the zone. Sims was there. Now it's Arnold back for Sims. Up high, shot, stick save, turned aside. Sims again with it. Looks to play to the slot area. Hurley down to the knee. He plays it up to the right wing side for Fleischacker. Off the glass and back into the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knight zone. Newhouse for Sims. Gets a stick on that. No ice on the play. Pretty much going to wrap it up for this period with 5 to go as the Pioneers will be content to just keep it wide and keep it away from the Red Knights as they'll take a hefty 4-goal lead into the second intermission as they lead by a score of 4-0.
Yeah, I think Hill Murray really put in a textbook second period. I think they started to flex their offensive muscles just a little bit, but you know, the couple penalties that Benilde St. Margaret's took, they came back and kind of bit them a little bit, but that's kind of been kind of the method of operation for Benilde St. Margaret's early in this season. They just make the one mistake that comes back and bites them. Once they iron those out, this team's going to be pretty formidable. But Hill Murray, that was their period as far as territory and such. But obviously it's 4-0 for a good reason.
Tonight's coverage is presented in part by True Hockey. That's true-hockey.com. Hockey equipment from sticks, gloves, skates, and more. Goodwood Hockey, that's goodwoodhockey.com. Apparel locally owned and unlike any other. The Goalie Club, that's goalieclub.com. Des Christopher, you can improve your game and achieve your goals in the net. Hockey IQ, that's hockeyiqacademy.com. Smarter players equal more effective players. We're going to take a timeout. We'll come back with more, especially the start of the third period from the St. Louis Park Rec Center. The Pioneers lead. We are between periods of our Let's Play Hockey.com High School Hockey Game of the Week. And we are honored to be joined by Des Christopher from the Goalie Club. And he's also the goalie coach at Shattuck St. Mary's. He has a long career playing the game professionally in Europe. He also was a member of the Minnesota State Mankato Mavericks. I better get that right, Des. And you've taken all of those experiences from your hometown of Calgary, Alberta, to Minnesota and have been making a difference in goaltenders. So I want to welcome you aboard to our coverage. And can you tell us about the Goalie Club and what you get done with your organization?
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Yeah, the Goalie Club, we started in 2002, primarily in Minnesota, where I'm based, and my partner was out of Michigan. We've since kind of, I've taken over the whole thing, and we train goalies all year long. The bulk of our work is done in the summertime with our boarding schools and our day camps, and we do private lessons and skill training in our holiday camp down here at Shattuck St. Mary's.
Now, you were mentioning to me earlier in the day that you really work on player-to-coach ratios and keeping them where kids are getting a lot of attention. Can you talk on that too?
Yeah, we found, you know, when you work with a goalie or like in a team setting, it's generally one coach and one or two goalies. So we've delivered that into our camp setting, and it's worked real well where you can get to know the kid and they get your trust, and we get to find out and fine tune their game on more of a personal level.
Dez has been at Shattuck St. Mary's since 2005, has seen goaltenders from around North America and the world for that matter. And I'm just curious to know if you've got different types of goalies, whether they're the Finns or the Swedes, the Canadians, the Americans. Have you been able to hone in on certain styles that you're seeing from around the globe?
Well, I think any real good coach takes a mixture of what they see from different styles and different nationalities and try and blend it in together. And I'm no different. I like what I see from the Finnish goalies, the Swedes, what the U.S. guys have done, and obviously with Carey Price taking over in his positional play, the Canadian goalies. So it's a mixed bag of things that we try and teach the kids and put it into their kind of game and their athleticism and hone in on their positioning and their skill set. And that's what we tend to do.
If I'm a goaltender and a goaltender family, what can they expect? I mean, you know, so when they come into one of your camps with the Goalie Club, which you can get at thegoalieclub.com, what do you want them to take away?
Well, they're going to get a vast amount of knowledge. My staff has been trained under me. We're one of the only programs where almost every coach that I have has trained through the Goalie Club. So they know my expectations. And we work together as a team, as a staff. We talk about the kids every day. We try and focus on what their needs are and what they're really good at. So we build their confidence that way. So the kids will come in. They'll have to work hard because we do a lot of second save opportunities. So they'll have to be able to work on puck placement and positioning and depth and angle. You name it. We're going over it, and it's in a way where we talk to the kids in a professional manner. We gain their respect, and they gain ours. It's phenomenal.
I have spoken for a while here, and to any of our listeners with Dez, he knows his position. He knows the game. He knows how to coach. I would recommend you check out everything at thegoalieclub.com. Can you also provide your number that people could call you at if they have further questions to attend your camps?
Yeah, I'm available most anytime if I'm not on the ice, and that's at 612-210-5944.
Dez, thank you very much. We're going to continue with more high school hockey action on letsplayhockey.com.
And welcome back to the St. Louis Park Rec Center second intermission here between Hill Murray and Benilde St. Margaret's. Hill Murray on top 4-0. Brett Johnson here doing a little pinch hitting for Pete Wagner. I think he sees Barty's wandering somewhere around the St. Louis.
Socializing.
Yeah, socializing. That's exactly what he loves to do. What do you say here, Bart? We go through some scoring here from the second period.
I'd be happy to do that.
Let's
do it. There was plenty of it. It's all Hill Murray as it stands, but it started out, and this was a really nice goal. Watch the play, and it's Neubauer that actually kind of makes this happen. It's number 25, gets it out to Brock Bremer, and that's his second goal of the contest, fourth of the season. Really, goaltender ever didn't have much of a chance on that one, but just a kind of lack of positioning, but puck control, but really nice dish, one-time shot, picked it blocker side, so did a nice sequence by the Hill Murray Pioneers.
Let's even go ahead and get to that third goal coming up now. We'll go ahead.
Well, this one was so good. Well,
yeah, it was so good. We had to watch it multiple times.
We're going to watch it one more time. Now, this one, there's a little bit of discussion in the area because I my eyes are kind of old, but I thought it was Mike Fleischacker that actually made that. But Scott Moyer actually got the credit for the goal. Here's Moyer right here with that initial shot, but the rebound came over, and it was Fleischacker that actually put that one away. Obviously, it wouldn't have happened without Scott Moyer's involvement on that one, but I think it was Fleischacker that got that. We'll look at it again. Just a little bit of an offensive breakdown by Benilde St. Margaret's. Good save by Everett, but the lack of control on the rebound, a tough job for a goaltender to do, but that was put in by Fleischacker. Brought it to 3-0, and that one was at 10:02 of that period. But again, that was just Hill Murray taking advantage of a couple miscues by Benilde St. Margaret's in their own zone.
Yeah, absolutely. And looking for the fourth goal here for you, Bart, if we can pull it up. And we do have it right here. Where, this was really a tough one for Benilde St. Margaret's as well, falling behind 4-0 here in the second period.
Absolutely.
Just on the power play.
And on the power play. They're on the final minute of a five-minute major, and it was Sontag that took that shot, and I believe it was Nath got credit for that goal. Nice redirection. I think that they were actually planning to do that because there's a lot of traffic in front of the goaltender, so those good low tippable shots, but nice redirect on that one by Nath. That's his third goal of the season. Brought the advantage to 4-0 Hill Murray, and that's where we stand right now.
Taking a look at that one more time. Did that go off his skate on that side?
Well, it could have gone off the skate, but again, it wasn't a kicking motion, so it's going to count either way. But if you got a stick on a very athletic play, but if you got a skate on a very heady play, but nonetheless, they all score. It's a line drive in the box score is what we say.
Yeah, exactly. And I think we have one more highlight here. This is just a nice save made by the Benilde St. Margaret's goaltender. Give him credit. Mm-hmm. Even though he's given up 4 goals tonight, he's certainly come up big with some nice saves in this one.
Well,
take a look at this one.
I think he's definitely been their best player tonight, bar none. And that was a good one. But, again, there you see that feed right out in front. And once again, that's the Bramer goal. But I think Everett, in the first period especially, I think that he really made a couple key saves that most times most goaltenders might have a little bit more of a challenge. But I thought he held in quite well and gave his team a chance to actually succeed. And that's that Kyler Yeo with a shot right on top of the dot in the scoring area. But really a nice glove save once again by Everett. Not only that, but I think he saw that at the last moment. So nice job by Hill Murray to interrupt his sight lines, but a better job by Zach Everett to track that puck, hold it in his glove. But that was a big save. Otherwise, we'd be, at a 5-0, and that's obviously going to be a very difficult comeback. 4-0 is tough enough, but 5-0 against the Hill Murray squad's almost too tall of an order.
Before we take our next break here, just a reminder, next week we got the Edina Holiday Classic from Braemar Arena. And, Bart, that's going to be a fun tournament. I think looking at the rankings, that's 4 of the top 6 teams in the state.
Yeah,
that's going to be some great hockey.
And, Brett, Pete always picks on me because I do love this tournament, especially the time of year. It's before the holidays, so the rigmarole hasn't really started before the Schwann's Cup. And it's three games in 3 nights against very solid competition, a round-robin tournament. And as you said, 4 teams in the top 6 or 7, depending upon which polls you go to. It just promises to be a great tournament. But Thursday night's an exceptional night because it's the opening. Second night, everybody kind of got their anxieties out. And the third night's obviously the best night on Saturday where we play the round-robin, where Eden Prairie and Edina square off in that final stanza on that Saturday night. But that always promises to be a great one. But Grand Rapids and Elk River is always a spirited contest as well. So I'm really looking forward to it. So join us if you can. It promises to be a great tournament.
Yeah, that's coming up next Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Check it out. Let'splayhockey.com. Take one more timeout and have the third period on the way next here from the St. Louis Park Rec Center.
We are between periods of the Let'sPlayHockey.com game of the week, and we are pleased to be joined by Kelly Meza, the owner of Goodwood Hockey, and she has a great product. Kelly, thanks for joining us between periods here today. And can you tell us a little bit about your company? I know it's an apparel company, but how did it all get started?
Sure. Thanks for having me. Actually, we just started, and it was a quick start. Last year at about this time, I was just having a really difficult time finding hockey-related apparel for my kids for Christmas. And in passing, my husband kind of offered up the suggestion that I should start my own company. And at the time, I was a medical consultant for a pharmaceutical company, thought it might be a good side business. And the stars kind of aligned. I left the company that I'd worked for many years and started this full-time just the summer of 2016, so we're just a few months old.
And how's it been going for you? You've got a really unique product line, which I like, is different from anything else I've seen.
So thanks so much for that, and it's going really well, and I think that where we're different, there's a lot of great Minnesota-based hockey apparel companies out there, but I think the direction and the focus that I'd like to head is for the whole family and for the whole country, and actually even expanding maybe into Canada or Europe in the future. But instead of just focusing on adult wear or men's wear, we have a line just for girls that are similar designs to any kind of gender neutral design, but with a more feminine cut garment. We focused on trying to source all of our garments from U.S. manufacturers whenever possible. And so we have something for everybody, whether you are a hockey player or a hockey fan. We have items, clothing, and accessories for just about anybody who loves hockey.
And we're talking at the individual and team level too, correct?
So right now we do individual levels, although We have provided the same shirt for all the team members on certain teams if they request that. We don't do team-specific wear at this time, but that doesn't mean we're not open to that in the future.
Your website is goodwoodhockey.com. I'm looking at it right now in your holiday shop 2016. You've got everything from tees to long-sleeve tees to great baseball hats to winter caps to everything. So do you have particular large sellers? You also have baby apparel too, which you don't see much of.
We do. We just started with our baby apparel. We have several styles that are start at a 2T, and that includes a Zamboni or an ice cleaner design that's actually hand sketched by a Florida-based artist.
And it's really impressive.
It to
it's
a
cool
garment. Thank you. She actually drew that with a pencil. And then wow. For the holiday shirt, we branched into infant sizes, starting as little as 3 to 6 months. It's had a great response, and we look forward to providing more options as we move along here.
No, seriously, on that Zamboni shirt, and this is part of what's unique about what you do. Little kids love the Zamboni. I was one of them. If I were a little guy and was a girl and able to get that shirt, I would wear it religiously. You got to check it out on goodwoodhockey.com. Click shop, and I think that's just an automatic, natural gift. You've got a lot of really good looking stuff on here. So
thanks so much.
A lot
of those styles have matching big people versions as well. So there's a big version of the ice cleaner for dads or moms or big brothers or sisters as well.
Well, it's a fascinating piece for sure. So, is there any other way to get a hold of you from a shopping perspective, or is it the best way to go on goodwoodhockey.com?
The best way to go is goodwoodhockey.com. We were fortunate to be a part of the holiday boutique at US Bank Stadium a few weeks ago, and we will happily be a vendor at the Let's Play Hockey Expo this spring. And online is the best way to get me, and I am a direct line by email at service@goodwoodhockey.com. You get me personally at that email, that's service@goodwoodhockey.com. And we're also available on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Goodwood Hockey.
Kelly, thank you very much. That's goodwoodhockey.com. We'll return to the rink with more action of the Let's Play Hockey Game of the Week. And there's this tale of the tape. The Hillmary Pioneers lead the Vanilla St. Margaret's Red Knights by a score of 4-0, Bart. And you know, it's going to be a third period. I think if you're Bill Lechner, finish strong and get the results you're looking for.
I really don't think that's going to be a challenge for his team. He's just such a good coach, and he has them poised and focused. I think the challenge is in front of Coach Ken Pauley. I think what they need to do is really win this period. You know, it's 4-0. Obviously, it's going to be a huge uphill battle for them to get back into this contest and actually tie it up. But I think that what they need to do is find some positives, and that's working out the little mistakes and little breakdowns in their own zone, winning the loose battles. They did that last period, so those are encouraging things. But I think that Benilde St. Margaret's obviously still has to mind their defensive zone, but they just have to get some pressure on Jake Begley, the senior goaltender for the Pioneers, and they have to do it early and they have to do it often.
Shots on goal through the two periods favor Hillmary by a 19-9 margin. 3 second period goals by Brock Bremer, Mike Fleischacker. That was changed officially, Bart.
Yes, indeed it was. And I'm smiling.
Boy, oh boy, you were ready to take somebody out.
Well, my eyes usually fail me. That one, they didn't. It's encouraging.
Bounding on goal. Well, the advanced age for Bart Archer, it's all working.
I'm sorry, what? Here we go.
Yo with it. Bothered at the line. Played to center. Garcia comes away with it. He'll race across the line. The Red Knights looking to get something started here in the third period as it's Yo to play that one in down the left wing side. Nice pass on the way in. Helgeson took that one from Bremer. No go.
Schweitzer slow to get up.
Yo there. Kicked back. Oh, nice pass there for Bremer. He has two already looking for the Hattie. Loses the handle down low. Up high it goes. Snapper. That one buzzes wide. Everett battling away down from the goal mouth area. McLeod tried to play that one in. That was stopped by a busy stick there of Bremer, but instead the Red Knights still find an opportunity down low. A nice save by Begley. Peter Moran is there, one of the captains. Plays that one to the slot area. Now Sims, another captain, off the, I don't know, that was in the knob quite, but we'll say
the
shaft.
Right on.
Boy, I know that feeling well.
But Benilde showing some good fight early in this third period.
sent back in. One thing about Ken Pauley's teams, they will never quit, and they'll always play with a purpose and a tempo. And we know Bill Lechner's teams always have so much discipline and play within the style of play that he's looking for from his team, and they use the whole ice.
Well, and they really don't give you a whole lot of opportunities because they don't have any breakdowns or too many miscues, really. And when they do, they have a pretty solid goaltender in Jake Begley.
Up to the line. It's held in. Nice job on the backhand. That shot by David Quast is wide of the mark. They try to play that up the boards. It's a nice job there to keep it alive by Joseph Quast. Down low. It looked like they had the short side open. That one goes wide. And now Peter Moran with it. Touches a pass. Left wing side. Too far for Barr. And it's sent right back into the Red Knight zone. A twig goes flying and sits loose into the Red Knight zone.
It'll come into play.
Oh, that's why we foreshadow.
Oh, they took it out. They picked it up.
Oh, that's a bummer. Without doubt, without a doubt, we know that's been our theme for years, Bart. It doesn't matter where it is on the ice. It'll take a puck away from somebody.
Sometimes it's the most valuable defender.
The best defenseman attendee could have. Clark with it. Plays it rink wide. They'll look up ice. Collins tries to play a pass that was a little bit behind the oncoming Rue, and it's played back up by the Pioneers as they race through center across the checkered. Nath with it. He has one tonight, and behind the net it's Clark. Outlets too far for Rue, and the puck will be gathered in by Ooner. Long pass. That's off a stick into the Red Knight zone. Played up the wall by Spindler. Sliding over to make a play was Arnold. He's forechecked on the play. Now it's Hurley hustling in after that one. Hurley wins the race and the battle. Loses the stick, tries to win it with his feet. Gets a little bit of help from the spade work of Moyer. Jablonski is in there as well. Spindler comes away. He's going to ring the wall. And sliding over to make the play was Arnold. Arnold was there. Now Clark gives back up through center. Collins loses the handle. Ice it goes on the stick for Warner.
Offside.
And now they're going to let it go.
Again.
As it's played back up through. And across the line it goes. They'll play to center. Kasurik will chase this one down through the center ice area. His father, Pat, was the top leading for quite some time. 10 now. He says there's been too many stars that have come through this program.
Well, hopefully there's going to be another star in Ken Pauley's eyes that steps up this year and actually... I think offensive output is just going to be Coach Pauley's challenge. It looks like defensively they're pretty sound. They support each other quite well. They give the goaltender sight lines. But I think the challenge so far has been just who's going to put the puck in the net. And a lot of central scoring. Three goals from Peter Moran and then a goal from Jordan Rue and another one from Nick Sims. But that's all the tally so far. And this is going into the fourth game, almost complete the fourth game. So finding scoring on this Benilde St. Margaret team is going to be something that we're going to have to see unfold.
Scores! And the hats will be flying for Bremer. He comes in from the off wing and buries one past the glove of the goaltender, Zach Everett. And the Pioneers take the 5-0 lead.
Well, that'll be his fifth goal of the year, third of the game, as you said, Pete. But he's been all over the place, especially in the offensive zone. He's one of those players that warrants attention. You need to know where he is. But right at the dot, it looked like Everett showed him five hole, but he just went under the arm and above the pad on the glove side. Really a pretty nice shot. I think he was a little fortunate that puck had some eyes, but... Another good shot by Bremer with his third goal of the game. Now it's 5-0 Hill-Marie.
Moran with a touch pass. Don't forget, next week we'll have all 3 days, six games from the Edina Holiday Classic. We open up with the first game, which will feature the Eden Prairie Eagles and Elk River Elks, followed by the Edina Hornets and Grand Rapids Thunderhawks. Always a spirited day for sure between those two teams.
Well, as me and Brett alluded to, between periods while you're out socializing and satisfying all of your fans here, it's just four teams in the top six or seven, yeah, depending upon what the rankings are in this tournament. So, boy, Elk River's got a really nice squad as well. We talked the praises about Grand Rapids. Looks like we're going to get a penalty. But we talked the praise about Grand Rapids, but Elk River is nothing to sneeze at, too. So it's going to be an exciting 3 days of hockey, no question about that.
Absolutely.
That penalty is going to be on Joseph Quast for Hill-Marie.
We'll get 3 days in a row.
Indeed.
Of some of the best players we're going to see. There's some high-end players that'll be there are every week we do this, but I'll tell you what, it's going to be something special. So power play time for the Red Knights. Ken Pauley exercises his one and only timeout for the game. And he's going to talk things over on the power play.
as he and John Russo Jr. work the bench. There's a good look. Todd Grover on the camera. Great work for you, him there. Here's your hat trick there on the off wing. He just stayed patient. Loves to let the ladies know that he scored. Second time now.
Yeah. He's becoming way too familiar with them down there. But Zach Everett did a good job of coming out, challenging the shooter. Really didn't give him a lot to look at, but that puck had eyes. But that's what happens when you get goal scorers like Brock Bremer or players that can score goals. Sometimes those pucks have eyes. But three goals tonight, he's obviously been the driving force behind this Hill-Murray team. But there's so many people that have contributed to this 5-0 advantage on Hill-Murray.
There's the legendary facility that we will be at. We'll see big crowds there for sure.
Oh, yeah, and they're very vociferous as well.
And there's something about the alumni for Eden Prairie and Edina that come back to close it out. All the college guys like to let everybody know.
Yeah, and there's no
that they're wearing the pea coats or whatever else they wear.
And no shortage of scouts at that tournament either.
Oh, yeah, they're crawling all over the place.
Makes the parents nervous.
We'll see Craig Sarner,
Shane Shirla.
We'll see Gary Harker.
Oh, goodness.
Toronto Maple Leafs.
I got you, of course.
Well, I'll have the hat on.
You always work the Maple Leafs into it.
Boy, for a team that lost 3-2 last night, they looked pretty good, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. They showed flashes of brilliance. That's a good win by the Wild.
I don't want to digress here for 2 seconds, Bart. This is sort of an overtime radio show topic. There's a shot off the side of the net. Wrap around. Hey. They score! The Red Knights get on the board with a rebound wraparound shot by Ian Barr.
Yeah, Ian Barr, that's going to be his first goal of the year. But finally, this Red Knight team gets rewarded for all their hard work. Just as you can see a little traffic in front, we'll see the replay going on. But that is Ian Barr with his contribution. Pretty good job. A little bit of a wide shot. Caught the netting. I think that kind of messed him up a little bit, but they got it back out front, and Barr just did the wraparound short side, but it was something Bagley couldn't get over to cover. But a nice sequence by Benilde St. Margaret's. Again, I've said it before, it doesn't have to be pretty. It just has to be effective, but very good heads-up play by Barr on that one.
Well, you see that little collision there in front. That was a big play by Peter Moran.
Yep.
That opened things up, and they're having a chat there. Let's see if we can listen in. Are they saying that Moran interfered with the skater?
Well, I don't think he did. He actually maybe interfered with the defender, but it wasn't really part of the play, and it's in the front of the net, so it'd be very unusual if they called anything. They're going to give the credit to Benilde St. Margaret's on that goal. Now it's going to be 5-1. Bill Lechner wants a little qualification from the referees on that one, but there was some extracurriculars. Did it affect the play? Not so much, but just a nice play by Ian Barr.
Bill Lechner's just saying, what were you really talking about? Now Ken Pauley's going to say, why are you talking to him?
Right. We need to know.
Why? No. Knowing Ken, he's saying, why did you even talk?
Yeah. Oh, good call. Referees show respect to the coaches, and I kind of appreciate that. That way there's
calling
no
a great
barriers.
Game.
Absolutely. But now Benilde St. Margaret's has to have a little energy. They've scored in the second and third period. Well, they've scored in the third period, so they got that monkey off their back. Now it's time to build on that and move forward.
Spindler up the ice, cuts through one man, carries it down low to the forehand. It's 5-on-5 now after the power play tally by the Red Knights of Benilde St. Margaret's. Back up into the center ice area. It's going to be handled there by Helgeson. Plays back in behind the net. Yo comes together. He gets spaded out of there by Arnold. Little outlet to the left wing side.
Penalty
Puck has got it along, and
it's going to be a cross check, too.
Yeah. But, in the offensive zone, mind you.
Yeah, those are kind of tough penalties to take, especially when you're holding on to a lead as it stands. But
it's on the Red Knights, by the way.
Oh, it is on the Red Knights.
In the defensive zone.
Okay, well, why didn't they blow the whistle earlier then? But that is going to be Brian Arnold that's going to go to the box. Again, now it's going to be a power play once again for Hill-Murray. Boy, Kyler Yeo just got kind of crushed on that one. But nice rush prior to that by Spindler on that by Benilde St. Margaret's. If they can get a rushing defenseman, that changes the dynamic of how they defend. But nobody went back to cover, so it was four guys deep in the zone, and then Hill-Murray came back with numbers.
One-timer buzzed wide of the net. Four-goal lead here with 10:37 to go in the third period for the Pioneers of Hill-Murray. Yeo with it, snapper. That one dribbles through. Loose change is going to be gathered in by Helgeson. Plays up high off the stick of Breezy. Yeo comes over. Breezy there as well. Now it's going to be Bremer, the man with the hattie already. There's a wrist shot. Oh, that one with touch off the side of the post. Kind of caught the outside of it on its way in. Kyler Yeo plays to the corner, gets it back. A little catch played there with Neubauer. Puck to the goal mouth area. Sits loose. Moran muscles it through center. If he hustles, he has an opportunity here. And a nice play defensively. Great position by Breezy.
Showed some strength, too.
Rink wide. That's behind the intended receiver. Look out. The puck rolls into the right circle. And it's going to be Bremer to come away with it. He'll calmly hang on. A walk down low. There's a chance down low. Scores! Great positioning and a big goal there. That makes it 6-1. Pioneers as Yo dents the twine.
Well, again, a tic-tac-toe. This is a very effective line. They've been very solid on their puck movement. Really starts with Bremer over to Yo, and then it gets over to Helgeson, and he buried that one. But really some patience on this one.
Well, this group, look at Yo, just knows he finds an opening, and that's where you score from right there. And he made no doubt about it. Got to give him credit. Did not look to the gals behind the net. Another day at the office. Act like you've been there. Very Al McAdam-like, the former North Star.
Absolutely. But for Yo, that's his second goal of the season. Two-point night for Kyler Yo. He's been very effective. But that whole line is just the way that they possess the puck, the way they move the puck, they're very difficult to defend. And that was a prime example of that right there.
I think on the Yo story, it's great that he's able to stay here. His father, Mike, obviously gets a job with the St. Louis Blues. And he's down there working with the club, who, by the way, are in action tonight. So hopefully he can see this on the replay.
Sure.
But he's given a chance to play out his senior year, staying back at home with his mom. And, I think to experience a senior year of Minnesota high school hockey is well worth it. It's when you can really kick it in and get after it. And to play it for a guy like Bill Lechner, what more can you say?
Well, Coach Lechner is so good at developing players, not only as hockey players, but as young men. And it's the transition from a secondary role to a primary role, which is what Kyler's experiencing now. And he's actually embracing it, relishing it, and actually succeeding. So,
well, his group, that line is looking really good,
yes,
like you said.
Absolutely.
Knowing where each other is, supporting the puck. Down low it goes. Now 5-goal lead for the Pioneers regained after the Red Knights scored on the power play. Now it comes up high to the line. There's a wrist shot that's blocked on the way in by Oberle. Now it's Newhouse ahead for Collins, too far. Oberle again, stick save Everett. He's under siege.
You got to block him out.
And down they go, back up to Oberle. He plays it rink wide to his partner. That's Uhner. Shot, blocker, pad save. I'll tell you what, Everett has made a number of saves that are positional. He's been square to the puck, and because he knows his position, he has his hands up appropriately. He's making saves because he's setting himself up. I like how this young player is finding his positioning very well. He's a senior, but he's been playing great here for the Red Knights.
Yeah, the part I like about him is he never quits on the play either, Pete. He makes the first save, but he doesn't just bail. Boy, that was kind of aggressive at the end of that, but that's just Benil going to the net. But I think Everett has been really one of the shining stars on this Benil team. But I think his defense, for the most part, is really giving him a chance to see the puck. And I think that if the goaltenders at this level can see the puck, generally they can save it. But they've done, really, about 95% of the time, a good job of blocking out and giving their goaltender a chance. It's that 5% that's really come back and stung them.
So we'll face off after a penalty on the tail end of that play. That will be whistled down to Brett Oberle, the freshman.
Couple freshmen represented tonight, and they're blending in for all the right reasons.
Everett is going to have to play that one himself, as there's Bremer. McLeod guides it up to the left wing side. It's going to be handled on the way down by Barr. Sims with it from the right wing side, gets away from one man, bothered on the play. McLeod's shot's deflected, and it's played to the right wing side by Bremer. Tried to find a man streaking through the neutral. That was Helgeson, and now it's going to be handled by Newhouse. Newhouse gets away from his man. Nice forecheck by Helgeson to create some issues. Up high it goes. Barr with it. Bremer tried to work it to some open space. Couldn't get it done. Here come the Red Knights back the other way. That one's deflected up in the air. Barr with it to the corner. Moran is bumped on the play. Nice position by Breezy to force him to make a decision. They find an opening. Oh, they don't get it. Picked off by Newhouse. Nice play there. Sims, shallow angle, shot, stick save. Begley was there. That gets through the outstretched stick of McLeod, and it's going to be Newhouse to regroup.
Boy, this Pioneer defense has really played a whale of a game tonight. They're so difficult to try to navigate and get some space on that one, and Derek Freezy or Breezy just actually showed how difficult it can be to even get a shot off.
Sims with it behind the net. Looks to find some room as he's hounded. Nice job by the Pioneers to keep it on the perimeter. Sims wrist shot that ramps up off a stick off the glass. Behind the net it goes. Moran is there. Puts on the brakes. Up high it goes. McLeod, nice job to draw his man in. There's a shot that's deflected. That's off Moran's equipment. Opening found and sent the length of the ice on a fine play by Petronik.
Well, just 8 seconds, 7 seconds left on the penalty to Oberle. Then they're going to be back to 5-on-5, but Hillmurray's done a great job of killing this penalty.
Snapshot taken. Puck rolls into the goal mouth area. Shot, rebound. Puck's loose. They score! From the goal mouth area, they find an opening off a couple of rebounds, and it's in the back of the net, and a 6-2 lead now for the Pioneers after the that's an even strength goal, correct, on the Peter Moran goal?
Indeed it is. It was 5-on-5, but Peter Moran with his fourth goal of the season. And it's really more of a feel-good kind of a deal. Look at Begley just battling and battling, but it just came to Moran, and he just kind of chipped it up and over. One of those soft lob wedge shots, but line drive in the box score, as we said. But now it's 6-2, 5:34 left. Benilde just trying to win this period, and they've done a pretty good job of holding serve, but they just need to kind of finish strong in the final 5:25 of this period.
Red Knights turn the puck over back into center with Jablonski. He cuts to the middle. Newhouse walks down low. Lost the handle and the grip on the puck as it's Baublitz to make the play. To the right wing wall. Rue is there. He's checked on the play. Tries to protect it and make a play. Gets a little bit of help from Jablonski. Back to the corner. McNeil was there. Now to take over, it's Uner. Touch pass to Yo from the right wing side. He stood up and forced a play to center. Arnold loses the handle. And it's sent right back in front of the bench area for Jerome Newhouse. Off the boards, Jablonski was there, McNeil to take over, but look out, here comes the pressure from the defense of Troy Trischler. We have a penalty.
That might be on Benil St. Margaret's cross check. He just kind of hit him from behind. Just kind of an innocent hockey play, but nonetheless, the referee's right on that call, but Benil St. Margaret's going to be a man down, 4:36 left in regulation time. Penalties to Jerome Newhouse.
I always struggle. There it is right there. Yeah. God, I know her. I always struggle when the penalty is called and they blow the whistle. Mm-hmm. We look at them for about 10 minutes, and then they decide to show you what it is. It's right. Like, okay, we see you.
The dramatic pause.
Yeah, exactly. We've got you.
But really not a penalty that needed to be taken. Jerome Newhouse has actually been a pretty driving force of this Benilde team tonight, but just a penalty that really didn't need to happen.
Yo with it. Power play again for the Pioneers. We're going to send that one in. Just flipping it in on goal. Breezy's mixed up his looks from the blue line. He hasn't put missiles in on every play. And there he had a good scoring chance, but Everett better to keep the rebound control.
Well, it's kind of a lesson for your youngsters kind of a thing. You don't need to take the big windup. Obviously, the accuracy of the slap shot isn't there. If you take the wrist shot, you can get it on goal. And as an example there, if Everett didn't make that great save, they could have had a good secondary follow-up opportunity, which they almost did.
Brett Johnson is going to have a condensed game for us on the highlight package. Is that correct?
That is.
So you'll be able to see that on YouTube, or we'll have the full replay of this game as well immediately following, so you can relive all of the festivities here from the Rec Center in the St. Louis Park Arena.
Well, I think the Bremer family might be tuning in to watch this one again.
You think? Played down low. Quick puck movement for Yo.
Or Mike Yo.
Played back over for Yo once again to the slot. Bremer with a redirect. Can't get it there. Nice job to get the shins on that for Breezy. Well wide of the mark. There's a shot through traffic. Yo will take over from the left wing side. Walks up high, has plenty of room to work. Plays it down low for Neubauer. Yo again, looked in, takes it back out. Plays back up high for Breezy. Yo walks, the movement away from the puck. Continues for the Pioneers. There's a shot off the pad. Nice butterfly save there by Everett. Bart, I've been impressed with him tonight. There's a give and go. Oh, actually sort of a give and go. It started with Yo, and then it kind of came back and forth. All three were involved with that.
Well, I just like the patience.
Johnny on the spot.
I like the patience of Kyler Yo. Doesn't get too excited, doesn't get too enthusiastic. He just makes the right play at the right time, but he's a very heady hockey player.
Bremer just waits for three guys and sort of slides away, somehow maintains possession.
Right.
Is he the player of the game?
Oh, I don't know how we could give it to anybody else, to
okay.
be honest.
Well,
I mean,
there's
a lot of honorable mentions, but
I
as
think
far
you're
as
right.
the driving force, you're right.
Now, you take him out of it, it looks a little bit different.
Well, a little bit.
He just creates some issues from a speed perspective and skill, and he can hang out of the puck and
you know what, not the biggest guy, but he uses his body so well, Bart, to create extra opportunities.
Absolutely, and that's what separates the good players from the really good players, I hate to say it. Plus, he skates with his head up, too, which is very important.
And I've always said, you show me a player that can catch a pass anywhere, and that anybody can make a pass, but if it's up about knee-high and you're pulling it out of the air full stride, now you're a player.
Right, you're showing your athleticism, but I've been very impressed with Hill Murray. I didn't really know what to expect coming in because, you know, to me it was more, I've even called it more of a lunch pail good where, you know, they don't really have the standout guy, but they have a bunch of really, really good players. I might recant that statement a little bit and say they might have a couple stars in the making on this squad, but Benilde St. Margaret's is really, when they're good, I think it's good for high school hockey. Love them or don't like them, I think Benilde St. Margaret's is going to be heard from. They just have to kind of find their identity a little bit more, and it's been a little longer process than I think they're comfortable
with.
They
don't need to be heard from now. I think that's the most important
Indeed.
Component to the thing. But when you look at the Hill Murray, ranked number 14 in the state, there's got to be a lot of really, really good teams ahead of them. I don't think all of them are.
Well, indeed.
And it's a course, and it's a period, and it's a coach's poll, and I get all of that. But it's fun fodder to talk about.
Sure.
You know, it's interesting that your top four teams – in Prairie, Stillwater, Grand Rapids, Elk River. Three of those four teams have first place votes. Who voted against Eden Prairie? I mean, I'm not saying anything against Stillwater and Elk River, but I mean, how could you really?
Well, it's kind of a dare to be different. There might be a vendetta or somebody's feelings got hurt or something like that. But
basically, they went into running time against you? I don't know.
Yeah.
I mean,
well, rankings, again, to a certain degree, at least at this time of year, is just fodder at the water cooler, just something to talk about.
Well, we're talking about it now.
Indeed, we are. But I don't think Hill Murray, obviously, if they're the 14th rated team, the state of high school hockey in Minnesota is pretty good.
Indeed. Coming up next for the Hill Murray Pioneers, they've got what I would call a rivalry game with the Monty Medi Zephyrs. There's a save made there by Everett. Might have been wide of the mark. And then they'll have a game against Tartan at the Tartan Arena in Oakdale. That one's coming up on Thursday, December the 15th. Man, it's already coming up toward it's early December, but wow, Pat save, rebound, scores! 7-2 the score as the Pioneers continue to pour it on here in the third period.
Yeah, and that was Weston Newbar, I believe, that scored that one. He's actually quite a game. In fact, as far as player of the game, he might work into the conversation. It's hard to argue with three goals, but Newbar's had a couple helpers tonight. Now he finally got the tally, but it was a nice one just under the crossbar. You can see just the follow-up rebound. Puck rolling, I don't think that hurt him a whole bunch because that actually helped get him some elevation on that one, but you have to feel kind of a little bit bad for Zach Everett. He's played quite well, giving up seven goals. To say that to a goaltender, I'm sure he's got a lot of pride going on, but he's actually gave his team a chance to compete tonight.
He did through one period and into the second. There's a rebound on Begley. He was there to make the save, and there's a little extracurriculars, but nonetheless.
Well, it's just been Benilde St. Margaret showing a little fight down low with Sims that tried to get the loose puck in front of Begley. And he ended up going down, and the defenseman actually took a little bit of offense to it, but no harm, no foul. Faceoff, 52, just under a minute, 52 seconds left. Faceoff now to Begley's left.
Well, and you look at the shots against allowed by the Red Knights through their three games, 31, 30, and 25. It looks like in this one they'll be at or near the 30 mark again. That's not a massive number, but it's something I think at this level you don't want to see too much of.
Right, but I think the stats that jump off the page is the Red Knights have actually outshot their opponents going into tonight 96-86, but they've been outscored 12-5. And so they're having a little trouble finishing the play, and that's something that you just have to kind of focus on as far as how to finish. There's no real secret recipe, but you have to get the opportunities to get the shots on goal, and I think that's the increment that they have to focus on right now.
The Red Knights will head to the Eden Prairie Community Center for a game on Saturday at 7 o'clock.
It doesn't get easier for them,
does
it?
Yeah, the Casey Middlestad show.
Right.
Then there's another sectional game for the Red Knights coming up next week against the Hopkins Royals on the 17th. And then they'll take on Woodbury, and then it's to the St. Louis Park Holiday Classic.
Which is also a nice tournament as well.
Absolutely. John Barger runs a quality tournament each and every year. We'll probably be here for one of those games on the Thursday night game of the week.
Sure.
We left that in as a flex game
because
of all the tournaments. By the way, the schedule, subject to change.
Just so we put that out there.
So we're not doing a game on Saturday.
Correct. We're just going to get ready and focus on that 3 days and three nights at that super spectacular fun event, the Edina Holiday Tournament. I'm sorry.
Right, Brett? You can't wait for that, can you? Are you kind of in the tank for Eden Prairie? Or have you turned on him now?
No.
He's turned on him.
No, he's too fair.
Oh, you're a Thunderhawk guy. Okay, All right.
Well, I always said...
You like the underdog thing, the David Goliath, gotcha.
Yeah, and Grand Rapids is the underdog?
Well, not now. Yeah.
now, but I've always had an affinity for the Thunderhawks. I just love the Halloween machine, but they always bring a nice brand of hockey down to Braemar Arena, and I'm looking forward to watching them play.
Puck gets flipped up and out of play with 12.4 seconds to go.
The last minute that never ends. Did they
ooh,
stop
Bert
doing,
Archer.
Did they stop doing the chuck-a-puck here?
Well, what I love about this place, there's just no monkey business. You just get in, you get out, you're done by nine, boom.
Part of the fun is watching the people down by the glass, and when they can't get the pucks over the glass.
They pick them up, and then they throw them.
And then they throw them. Second chance is what they call it, a mulligan.
Yeah, so what happens if you're the guy that picks it up that doesn't clear the glass, and then you throw it and you win? Do you demand 50%?
Well, you at least negotiate a little bit, but that's where the negotiations open.
That score is correct. 7-2 on your score bug right now as we wind it down to 1 second to go. And that does it. The Hill-Marie Pioneers are victorious by a score of 7-2 here from the Rec Center to improve their record to 3-0. The Red Knights, meanwhile, fall to 1-3 on the campaign. Bart, your Let's Play Hockey player of the game?
Well, I think it's going to be Brock Bremer. He had 3 goals, his 3rd, 4th, and 5th goals of the season. 3 goals tonight, really a driving force. Obviously, if we started doing the honorable mentions, we'd be here for a good period of time because there were a lot of quality performances tonight by the Hill-Marie Pioneers, but they just seem like they're a team that's going to get better and better and better as the year goes on. And they play a pretty tough schedule, so I think come the holiday season, I think Coach Lechter is going to have them firing on all cylinders. Benilde St. Margaret's, it's a bit of a work in progress, I hate to say it, because I have a lot of respect for Ken Pauley, but he's got probably going to be challenged as far as probably one of his better coaching efforts is going to take to get this team to where they're used to being, but I think this team's going to be hurt from. They have some good speed. They defend pretty well. They have a good quality goaltender. I just think they have to get away from shooting themselves in the foot and those little breakdowns in their own zone. And I just think they have to develop a little bit more resiliency, a little bit more toughness as far as mentally. Don't get down if you get scored on. You didn't expect to shut this Hill-Marie team out, but they got out of this first period down only 1 goal, and I thought that they really started to show, but Hill-Marie sure flexed their muscles in that second period and really blew the game open.
Tonight's coverage presented by True Hockey. That's true-hockey.com. Goodwood Hockey, goodwoodhockey.com. The Goalie Club, that's goalieclub.com. And Hockey IQ, hockeyiqacademy.com. The final score reads, once again, the Hill-Marie Pioneers 7, the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights 2. We will be on the air for 6 games in 3 days from the Braemar Arena. And that's going to do it. Todd, thanks for putting us on the air once again. We really appreciate that. From the St. Louis Park Rec Center, for Bart Archer, Brett Michaels, Todd Grover, Joey Hetches, I'm Pete Wagner. So long, everybody.